Page 17, come to my house. We got two stabs again, and they're connected with these lines, so we're going to play them both at the same time. Treble clef in the top staff, bass clef in the bottom staff, 4-4 time. We've had all this before. Doesn't matter. We have to review it with each piece to make sure, because they'll change. So watch out. Starting out with right hand, you look it over. There's quarter notes and half notes and whole notes. We can handle that, I hope. It looks like it's one hand at a time until the last line. Now both hands are playing together. The right hand doesn't look hard. You've just got your regular notes. But you can do that, I hope. But the left hand's got these other notes. Let's look at the left hand in the last line there. At the beginning of it, you have an E and a G with 3-in-1. Your hand's in this position. So that you put them together. Put them there and just lower the hand down. And then the D and the G. And that's what you're doing. And then an F and a G in the second measure. That's the left hand. At the same time, the right hand's doing it. We want to hear the right hand. So if you can, you're going to play the right hand a little louder than the left. If you can't, do them the same. It just sounds so much better if you can, what we call, bring out the melody. We want to hear the melody. It's all about the melody. So you learn to play, you learn to control how loud you're playing anything at any time. Now you got to get the notes and the rhythm and all that junk out of the way first. But then you can go, okay, how loud is this going? That's what we do. One step at a time. Get the notes, get the rhythms, get the fingering, get all that worked out, and then go look in the dynamics, the louds and softs. Well, at the beginning, it's medium loud. Here, sort of loud, moderately loud, mezzo forte. And you're staying until the third line. Now you go loud. That's up a little bit. And then in the last line, now you're soft. See the P in the middle? This is the way it's supposed to be. You get one dynamic in the middle of the staff, and it's up to you to know how to use it. So it's soft. Well, the dynamic applies to the melody. So the melody is soft. You'll have to decide how soft. And the whole last line is soft. Well, if this is soft, the left hand has to be very soft, huh? Very soft. If you can't do that, play them the same, but play them soft. Get all that worked out, and then you go back and, okay, what's the speed? Well, it's quickly. Well, what's that? I don't know. It's quickly. It's not slow. If you're going to sing it quickly, how quickly would it be? And it's quickly. And then the last line, it says slower. Doesn't say how much slower, just slower. So it's sort of quickly. Moderately, I don't know, just slow it down. It changes the mood, because of the mood at the beginning is, come and see my toys. Yeah, sounds dirty, but that's what it is. And then the last line, suddenly it's pleasant. It's not sad. The words say you're still joy and toy and all that. It's just pleasant. It's like a dreamy thing. It's, oh, yeah. So now when we do the play with me, the metronome isn't going to do all that. We're going to take it all at one speed, slow. Now, I'm not doing dynamics. You do the dynamics on your own. I just want to check the notes and the rhythms. So let's do that now. Go ahead and put your hands in C position. I'll give us 4 counts. 1, 2, ready, go. Three, 4. Three.